In the last episode, we discovered many interesting things about coral reefs, and today we will continue this series by venturing back in time to centuries ago. There are many legends and myths surrounding corals and coral reefs. Their warm, vivid, and beautiful colors, as well as their ambiguity, have seduced the people who have come in contact with coral reefs throughout history, often attributing prophetic properties to corals, and sometimes even magical powers. Since various cultures across the world have been utilizing corals since prehistoric times, beliefs surrounding coral reefs have changed and grown alongside mankind. During ancient times, Egyptians believed that blood of the divine was present in corals, and they would often place pieces of coral in tombs as protection against evil spirits. These kinds of beliefs can also be traced back to Greek mythology, which states that a few drops of blood of the Gorgon Medusa, who was beheaded by Perseus, splashed into the sea. These drops of blood were said to solidify into the form of corals. Moving on from the Greeks to the Romans, these dominators of the ancient world believed that pulverized coral acquired healing properties when added to wine. However, at that time, they still did not really understand exactly what corals even were. Between 77 and 78 CE, Pliny the Elder, in his Encyclopedia Naturalis Historia, wrote that corals were marine bushes, and their eggs were fruits. After Pliny the Elder, many more writers and scientists have proposed their different ideas of what coral really was. From corals being soft like grass, and once beached it would become solid like a rock, to polyps being viewed as tiny white flowers. Romans also believed that corals could protect their children from harm. They believed that corals could be used to cure wounds caused by snake bites and protect from lightning strikes, often making their children wear coral jewelry as protection. Many other cultures across the world have used coral for the same purpose. From the 1st century CE onward, coral traders made coral routes from the Arabian Peninsula through Central Asia and to the Far East. Eventually, the communities they served integrated this valuable red gold into their local traditions, and corals even started being used as a currency in many eastern markets. In the 16th century, Spanish conquistadors introduced fine red Mediterranean coral to the American Southwest, possibly as rosary beads or ornaments on najas, which were silver pendants hung on horses' foreheads to avert the evil eye. In the modern world, some of these ancient traditions are still practiced and have been supplemented by new beliefs. Yet, whether one believes in these myths or not, corals will continue to intrigue people with their mystic beauty and fascinating existence.